Hello there, good afternoon. You're watching Proactive London and joining us today from Faron Pharmaceuticals, it's Marie-Louise. A warm welcome to you, Marie. How are you?
I'm great. Thank you for asking. I'm so happy to be with you, to be able to talk about Bex and the coming clinical development.
Excellent. Well, we'll get to that in just a second, but I want to learn more about you as well, because you're now the chief medical officer there, and you've had sort of 30 years, I believe, of experience in clinical oncology. Maybe tell us a bit more about your CV.
Well, you know, 30 years sounds like an awful long time. So I don't know, maybe we could say 20, but it actually is 30 years. So I started as a medical oncologist in Sweden like 30 years ago, and I've been working with patients for most of this time. About 10 years ago, I decided to join pharma, and I've been working for Novartis, which was a great start, you know, when you start your pharma career. And then I've been working with some other small biotech. So most of my focus in pharma has been on the immune suppressive tumor microenvironment. So I've always been trying to fight those immune suppressive macrophages. So I'm super happy to be at Faron right now, where I can continue that work.
Yeah, a perfect fit, isn't it, for your experience. In regards to what you're working on now, you mentioned it at the beginning. Talk us through it.
Yes, so I'm working on a monoclonal antibody that is targeting a CLEVER-1 positive immune suppressive macrophages. So we know that, I mean, immunotherapy is fantastic. The PD-1 blockers are amazing, but only 20% of patients that get PD-1 blockers actually do respond. And we know that one reason for not responding to PD-1 blockade are these M2 macrophages that provide a very immune suppressive tumor microenvironment that prevents the PD-1 blockers from working. Mm-hmm. So what we are trying to do is to treat patients with bexmarilimab, the monoclonal antibody that is directed towards CLEVER-1, and try to make that immune suppressive tumor microenvironment much more immune activated. Because an immune activation is absolutely necessary to get a good result from PD-1 blockers. So by first priming the tumor with our treatment and then adding a PD-1 blockade, we think that we can help a lot of more patients to respond to PD-1 blockers.
What's the demand for this? Why is it needed so much?
So, I mean, I think we've come a long way treating cancer patients. And the last 10 years with the PD-1 blockers, we actually see potentially cure of some metastatic cancer patients. But there is so much more to do here. So I'm really happy that we can hopefully offer another opportunity for these patients.
Absolutely. And when would realistically you be able to offer such a treatment?
You know, that is a very good question, Katie, and it will all depend on the mounting data. I mean, as you may know from our press release, we are really trying to work very hard on selecting the patients that actually will derive clinical benefit from the treatment, because I think it's very important to, I mean, those patients that will not respond to the treatment, maybe there are some other good treatments for them that can be offered. And we really want to focus on those patients that have a good efficacy from our treatment. So only data can tell exactly when we can go into the market.
Yeah, will be well worth it in the end, though.
It certainly will. I'm very hopeful, and I'm so looking forward to continue working on this project.
Excellent. Really, really exciting. And what kind of patients are you looking for exactly?
So in the current study, we are treating patients with a single agent. So in the current study that we have, we're treating patients that are heavily pretreated. So that means that these patients have received several lines of therapy before, and they have failed all of them. So there isn't a lot of treatments that are available for them. So these are the patients that we're treating right now. And we actually do see a very nice disease stabilization in patients, and we see a survival benefit. So that is super exciting. The next step is to go into different combination studies, because even though we have nice, interesting data on the monotherapy, I do think it's very important to be able to like help the patients that are not responding to PD-1 blockers moving forward. We also have some very interesting studies coming up in blood cancer, acute myeloid leukemia, and MDS, where we are combining with standard of care. There is lots of data showing that these indications, the blood cancers, could have a very good efficacy from adding this monoclonal antibody directed towards CLEVER-1, because these diseases have a very high content of CLEVER-1. Mm-hmm. And there is data showing that if we add Bex, the standard of care will work better. So we're extremely excited about that opportunity.
I bet you are. Well, we'll let you get back to it. Absolutely fascinating. And thank you for taking the time to speak to us, Marie-Louise, the Chief Medical Officer from Faron Pharmaceuticals.
It was all my pleasure. Thank you so much.